Converting custom shaders to URP. This video is aimed at tech artists, and some familiarity with shader development is assumed. If you've converted a built-in project to use URP, you've probably met the Render Pipeline Converter. This converter does a great job converting Unity's standard shaders, but it can't convert custom shaders that you or a team member have created. Here we have several meshes that use custom shaders written to use the built-in render pipeline. They display the magenta shader because the converter failed to convert these shaders and they remain incompatible with the universal render pipeline. You could use shader graph to create compatible shaders, but it's useful to know how to convert shaders using code. Cyan has a great website explaining in much more detail than I'll cover in this video how to create URP compatible shaders. See the link in the description below. In this video we'll look at a simple unlit shader. Lit shaders are much more complex, and for more advice about lit shaders you can't do better than Cyan's guide. If you want to code along, then download the repo. There's a link in the description. The repo comes with both code along and complete projects. To code along, you'll be using the code along project. Who'd have thought? If you open the scene, scenes, unlit, built into URP, small room, unlit, and double click unlit shader to open your code editor, you'll see a very simple built-in shader. You might be wondering why we need to do anything if this works, and it does work. But take a look at unlit shader in the Unity Inspector. Notice the not compatible by SRP Batcher message and the warning message about C buffer. These two items mean this shader is not optimized for URP. SRP Batcher organizes all materials using the same shader variant. The batcher will batch the multiple draw calls to reduce state changes, and that's a great performance boost for many scenes. Ensuring that all properties use the correct C buffer is a prerequisite of SRP Batcher compatibility. At the moment, this shader is using several features that make it unsuitable as a performance URP shader. While URP does support a CG program NCG block and UnityCG.CGInc, it's not recommended. Many Unity developers will be aware that Unity's been using an HLSL compiler for shader code for over a decade. To remove the legacy macros and includes, we now use an HLSL program, endHLSL block, and the new include file. It's quite a mouthful. Packages, com.unity.renderpipelines.universal, shader library, core.hlsl. This HLSL include file contains some important functions that replace ones we used in Unity CG CGInc. Don't use core.hlsl and a CG program block. It'll end in tears with variable redefinition problems. HLSL stands for High Level Shading Language. Given your shader knowledge, you'll be pleased to know that CG and HLSL are almost identical syntactically. A significant difference though is you can't call a function that hasn't already been declared. If we use the function calcColor in this frag function, because it's defined after the frag function in the script, there will be a compile error. If calcColor is defined before its use, then all will be well. This also means where you place an include is important. Core.hlsl includes all URP shader variables, matrix defines and transformations, and the core SRP library, but it doesn't contain any lighting functions, and it does not contain any default structs to use as app data and V2F. And the URP shaders you may come across will often use different struct names. App data is often now called attributes, and V2F will usually be called varyings, because when data is passed from a vertex to a fragment shader, values are interpolated based on the position of the pixel within a triangle. The name varyings better illustrates the fact that this data is interpolated. It varies across the rendered triangle. Of course, these are just naming conventions, and you're free to use whatever struct names you prefer. But when reviewing URP shader code, these are the struct names you'll find used. See the description in the link to more naming conventions. Core.hlsl doesn't contain pre-coded vertex or fragment functions. You'll need to create them from scratch. This page, see the description, basic unlit URP shader, has just about the simplest possible SRP Batcher compatible shader. We'll take the attributes and varying structs and the vert and frag functions for our shader. Our example shader needs texture coordinates, UV, so we'll add them to the attributes and varying structs. They use the text coord 0 semantic, and we need to add the render pipeline tag. Notice that instead of unity object to clip pos, we now use the function transform object to hclip, and also notice that unity URP shaders use the postfix os to mean object space, and hcs, or sometimes cs, to mean homogeneous clip space. This is simply a naming convention, and it isn't essential, but when reviewing unity URP shaders, it makes the code clearer if you understand the meanings of these postfix initials. Any properties we use should go inside a C buffer star n block that uses the parameter unity per material. If you're working on a more complex shader using multiple passes, all passes must use the same unity per material C buffer. We need to pass the attribute UV to the varying struct. All we now need to do is update the frag function to use the code from the previous frag function. HLSL does not support the fix type. It should be converted to half. The built-in library added fixed, but this legacy type is not supported by current GPUs, and the URP team decided to deprecate it. To complete this stage, I've removed the old frag and vert functions, removed the old structs, and added the varyings input. Okay, let's review the changes. 1. We've added render pipeline equals universal pipeline to the tags. 2. We've replaced the CG program block with HLSL program. 3. The Unity CG CG Inc has been replaced with URP core.hlsl. 4. App data is now attributes. 5. V2F is now varyings. 6. Transform object to hclip replaces unity object to clip pos. 7. Place properties inside a C buffer unity per material block. And 8. Fix type should be replaced with half. Back in Unity, you can now see that unlit shader is SRP Batcher compatible. Nice one! If you want to work with textures that support tiling and texture offsets, then you need to use a number of macros that contain useful shader functions, provided when you add the core.hlsl include file. If your shader has a diffuse texture map, like this one, then Unity's URP convention is to call it _basemap, not _maintext. Let's change _maintext to _basemap. This is not really required, it's simply a naming convention. Don't forget to change the reference in the C buffer block and the frag function. Because we're going to support tiling and offset, you can remove the no scale offset shaderlib specifier. If we examine unlit mat in the inspector, it now has tiling and offset panels. Often a C# script will use material.mainTexture or material.mainColor to reference the main texture and colour. How does the software determine from the shader which texture and colour to return? We turn to shader lab properties. Prefix the _basemap property with ; main texture and _colour with ; main colour. Using these Shader Lab specifiers allows the software to know which texture and colour to return. Now for the macros. To make tiling and offsets work correctly, we don't use text2D directly in the frag function. Instead, we use a macro. But for this to work, we need to declare the texture differently. We use a couple of macros to declare our sampler2D outside of the C buffer block. Texture2D underscore base map, sampler underscore base map. The actual 2D property is used in the texture2D macro. Use the same name prefixed with sampler for the sampler macro. The sampler macro declares a sampler state variable. See the description for a link to the Unity documentation about a sampler state. Now, the underscore base map inside cbuffer start end block. Change sampler2D to float 4 and add underscore st caps to the property name. This variable stores the tiling offset values set in the inspector. For a 2D property, XY stores the tiling values and ZW the offset, with Z being the offset X and W the offset Y. Finally, where we use text2D underscore base map in the frag function, replace that with sample underscore texture2D underscore base map, comma, sampler underscore base map. Notice we now have two parameters. The new macros help ensure that tiling and offset values are used as defined in the inspector. SRP allows you to share a sampler across multiple textures. For example, here we have two textures, but only one sampler. Notice when we call the sample texture2D macro, we can use the same sampler for both textures. For complex shaders, this can be very useful as some GPUs are limited to just 16 samples. Let's run through that again. 1. Add texture2D 2D property name. 2. Add sampler 2D property name. 3. Change the sampler 2D variable declaration to a float 4 and add underscore st. Change text2D 2D property name to sample underscore texture2D 2D property name sampler name. The naming conventions are important. Given the 2D property name, this is the name to use for the texture2D macro. For a single texture, it's usual but not required to prefix a texture name with sampler to give the sampler macro parameter. The texture2D and the sampler macros should be outside the cbuffer block. The cbuffer block should contain a float 4 that's the 2D property name postfixed with underscore st. To fully support tiling and offsets, we need to use another macro when setting the variance UV value. Instead of simply passing the text coord value as UV, we use the macro transform underscore text. This takes two parameters, the in UV value and the 2D property, here underscore base map. When you do this, you'll get a compilation error, undeclared identifier underscore base map underscore st. This is a perfect example of the importance of the order of things when using HLSL. The macro transform underscore text checks parameter 2 and uses the name to look for a float 4 value with the same name and the postfix underscore st. Although we define one in the cbuffer block, it's after the vert function. To fix this error, we simply need to move the vert function to after the cbuffer block. Now you have a simple, unlit URP shader with a texture modulated by a colour, and that is fully SRP Batcher compatible. Great work!